guys. We're doing our second part of our campaign series of Destiny of Kings, which is the second mission is going to be Angels of Fear. So we've got Efren bringing 3,000 points. We got Dustin bringing 2,000 points. Don't worry, there's some ways to balance it out. So it's going to be a very fun game. It's going to be enjoyable, and we'll be glad to show it to you guys. All right, see you there. Here's the forces of Ushat assaulting the hold of Dwindal. Dun, dun, dun. All right.
Mounted Sons, with the gift of Guise of the Deceiver and the Helm of Confidence. Then I have here, I forget what it's even called.
Wizard Conclave.
Wizard Conclave, or Magus Conclave.
Magus Conclave, yeah. Okay.
Here are Grotesque's Horde with the Brew of Sharpness. Here is Chieftain on Direfang with the Guise of the Deceiver and the Kevinar's Flying Hammer. Cool. Here is Supreme Overlord on Great Winged Halfbreed with the Boots of Levitation. This is a Slave Orc Horde that's afraid of everything.
Yellow-bellied.
Here, it's a Halfbreed Regiment with a Caterpillar Potion. I have four units of Tundra Dogs or Wolves.
Tundra Wolves.
Tundra Wolves. I have two units of Abyssal Berserkers. And one has a Blade of Slashing, which I'll have it be this fancy blade here. So I'll just add him to that unit. So that's Blade of Slashing. And then three Decimator Troops. And two units of Sons of Corgan with the Guise of the Deceiver and... That's it.
Okay. Yep. So this is the army of Ushat with Varangar allies. Right. Dwindal with ogre allies.
We got our shieldbreakers, a horde of shieldbreakers, a horde of ironwash rifles, and then a regiment of your iron guards. You got your three organ guns, and our stone priestess over there.
Oh gosh.
And then we have the shooters with
Brew Keeninus,
your giants. You got your boomers with the piercing one, so it'll be piercing two.
Mm-hmm.
Then you got your ogre warriors, and then your BSB.
BSB, all right. There's the army. All right, we'll go show you guys the table off deployment. Actually, let's roll for who goes first in deploying the first unit. Let's each roll a die. In the center, right now. So, Efren got a 6.
Alright.
And... Three.
Three.
So who's going to play first?
Huh? Deploy first?
Yeah.
He can deploy first.
You're going to deploy first, my friend.
Alright.
So I thought I would explain this mission a bit while showing you guys the table where we're at. So you can see the Magus Enclave, all the Varangar, and Abyssal Dwarves of Ushat. So that's a cross... Well, the dwarves setting up all along their castle, their hold, with their ogre mercs. So pretty much I'm going to explain this mission for you guys. So the second mission is Angels Fear to Tread. So in essence, this is a modified kill scenario. So Efren, which is playing the Abyssal Dwarves, and Varangar gets... 3,000 points, two 1,500 point armies to build for the scenario. Well, Dustin's army, he gets only 2,000 points, which has to be split up into 2,000 point armies. However, you'd think like, oh my gosh, a 3,000 point army is going to be so much better. Well, what Dustin gets, he gets a special thing with his castle walls, which we have set up right here, where we did some modification to it. He can get three special actions with the wall during the shooting phase. He can either fire a regiment of crossbows from his army, a cannon, or a lightning six spell from it. So he does get that benefit. And there's also another there's two more special rules to mention about. As with last game, Efren's Abyssal Dwarves have We Are Legion. So, or not We Are Legion, Yeah, We Are Legion gets We Are Legion, where he can bring units back that are killed. And one final rules is Clash of Titans. So in the actual rulebook, you get special characters, and if they die, the whole army would suffer a -2 to their nerve checks. But for this one, we decided to pick a particular unit. So for Efren's army, the particular unit that if it dies, his whole army would take a -2 penalty to their nerve is the Ironcaster on Halfbreed. And then for Dustin's dwarves, he picked this Shieldbreaker unit, which is... Iron Guards, sorry. He picked Iron Guards right here, which are on the back of the wall right over there. And that's the whole. Everything else is just a normal kill scenario. All right, we'll get to the match, guys. So, why don't we roll for who goes first?
All right.
So, Efren's going to roll and Dustin's going to roll. Oh, tie. All right, let's see. Two.
Oh.
Dustin, who's going to go first?
I'm going to go first.
So Dustin's going to go first. Right. Moving this ogre unit. Boom. Marching it forward right to there. And then moving the BSB right behind him. And then these boomers advancing up as well.
Right there. And then the dwarves.
And these dwarves are here. This horde. That's up to here. Done.
Stone Priest is moving up here. Then these guys are a 2-inch sidestep. Right there.
Alright. So, the dwarf wall. So, first attack action. What are you going to use from the wall?
The Jump Bombardments into his special...
Into... his Ironcaster. All right, you need a 6 to hit him with this.
Or 5 plus.
5, because there's no cover.
Oh, you're right, 5 plus.
Yeah. Boom.
Oh, it hits.
Mm-hmm. Here's the D3 plus. Yeah. Or D6 plus 3.
9.
9.
Oh, my God.
He's already scared.
Oh, jeez.
Who decided to attack the dwarven stronghold?
Oh,
that's five, so
nine of them. Though.
I missed 3.
So this one was from the previous
round. Yeah,
that's yeah. So 4.
So 6.
Oh, 6. Ouch! 6 wounds.
6 wounds.
6 wounds.
Yeah. And second shot. Okay, miss, and then the third shot. Miss. Okay.
So make up for all the good luck.
Okay, now we got all the other shooting.
All
right. Shots from the shooters into the Tundra Wolves right in front. Right. Hidden on 4s because of Brew of Caninus. And then wounding on 2s.
Everything?
Nice.
So 10? 10 wounds into the...
Yeah, 10 wounds.
So 10 wounds into the Tundra Wolves. Alright, any other shooting you'd like to do?
No.
That's all my
shooting. Because
nothing's in range.
Yeah.
Okay, so nerve checks.
Nerve checks.
So what would you like to start off with first?
Let's go with the Wolves first. Save the best
for
last.
10-12. 10-12,
alright.
It might be a little higher, but yeah.
10. No, sorry. Pops the Wolves. And then...
the special unit back there.
The, let's see, the 4... the Ironcaster. 6, 12.
12? Ooh.
What is that?
I think he's good too.
Yeah, I think I'm good.
Okay. Oh, he is A-OK at 15-17. Efren lets out a sigh of relief.
I don't know about the next turn.
Hide in the forest, my friend. All right, now we're going to go into your turn. Efren's advancing up his Orc Slaves.
Orc Slaves. They're pissed this time. They're going to sacrifice some of their kids.
But they don't yellow belly, right?
Yeah, so they don't yellow belly anymore. 18 inch, right?
Yep.
I can't go into the forest. I'll just stick with this. It's like 16 and a half or so.
Bam.
Oops.
And another dog?
Yeah, more dogs.
My dog! Alright. Friend's advancing up his dire fang. Alright.
Here.
The Sons of Corgan.
Sons of Corgan. I want to stay here.
Activating his sons. Or mounted sons. Advancing them up.
Mounted sons.
Right there. Yep. Advancing up his Abyssal Half-Breeds. 16 inches right behind the dogs. AKA the doggy shields.
Yep. Speaking about doggy shields.
Advancing these guys up. Right to there. And then those guys right behind. Boom. Good done.
Alright,
and the decimators.
Decimators will go as far as they can before getting in that forest. This one will do the same thing. Both of them will be marching. Or moving at the double.
Moving at the double. Okay. Slayers. Right behind. That's another.
Okay. And this one will be 2 inches before that. Oh!
Miniature party fell.
Yeah.
Okay.
And over here.
And the sun's advancing.
They got enough movement, I don't even need to really measure this. Yeah. The dwarves are actually slowing them down.
Don't say that.
Alright. And done. He moves his dragon from right to there, flying right to there, and he is done.
Yeah.
Advancing the Magus Enclave right to there.
To there, and then...
Magus Enclave at the organ gun.
Five plus.
6 inch.
Oh, double sixes.
Right, D3 each. Four.
Pretty good, actually. Hmm. Piercing 2. So, defense 5.
Threes.
Oh, two wounds. Two wounds on this organ gun.
Alright.
That's all you're shooting, right?
Yep.
So, Nerve, need a 10 to pop.
10 to pop?
10 to pop.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Roll a 10. No, don't roll a 10.
Eight, ten.
Eight, ten. So wavered.
It's wavered. Oh, man. That's pretty lucky.
Yep.
There we go. Wavered organ gun. All right. That's all of it for shooting. Now we go into the dwarves. Turn. Dun, 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 two.
This movement.
Guys, charging into the dukes.
Bams.
Boom. Over units. Change fit, you're gonna rotate and then walk into the forest 6 inches, up to 6 inches, and hang out in there, and the BSP right behind. Boom, moving the unit forward 3 inches, and they're done. Going right into shooting.
So, the boomer, how much boomers?
18 attacks.
18.
So, boomers are gonna fire 18 shots into the Sons of Corgan.
That
18 shots hitting on a force. So 9. Piercing 2. Defense 5. So needing 3s. So that is 7 wounds on Corgan. Sons of Corgan. Mounted Sons of Corgan.
Yeah, 7 wounds.
Ogre shooters firing into Sons of Corgan, needing 4s to hit. Now needing threes again.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. Quite a few.
Five.
It's
still a lot. I was like, ooh.
Miss 12.
Taking 12 wounds.
Taking 12 wounds. Priest is going to bane chant this organ gun. No chanting. Ooh.
It's pretty bad.
Two shots of this organ gun into the grotesques. Needing fives. So that is five hits. Now
piercing
wounded.
Two.
Piercing two. Defense five. So threes. Only three wounds on them.
Three wounds.
Only three wounds.
Yeah. We got another organ gun coming in there.
Yeah. Number two. Same thing, hitting on fives. Okay, so needing fives. Let's see. Way better. Now, same thing as before. This is when he's gonna Yahtzee out.
Threes.
Ouch.
So that is
six wounds.
Putting him at nine. So double the wounds from the last one. Nine wounds on that unit. It's a bombard.
Five right there.
Hit.
Is it D6 plus three?
New one.
Two.
So five.
Five needing twos.
Or, yeah.
Oh, no, five piercing. Needing threes. Needing threes.
Threes.
Piercing two?
Yeah. Okay, three more.
Three more.
Nine. He'll survive it. He'll shrug it off, right?
Yeah, he'll shrug it off.
Oh, no, that's on the Iron Caster.
This is for the Iron Caster?
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Lightning bolts from the wall into these wolves. Needing fours. Okay. So that's four of them. Piercing two. Or wait.
One.
Piercing one. Defense four. So the threes. So three wounds on the dukes.
Three wounds.
Three. Okay, you've got...
Oh, is this dogs?
No, those guys.
Oh. Those dogs. All right. Hold again.
Wow.
Ooh.
Ooh. Only one.
Wow.
Fizzed wound.
All right.
Fizzed out.
Think. Right. 20 shots from the shooter unit into these dogs. Why would you hurt a dog, man? Don't you feel terrible? Hitting on fives. It's only six.
Piercing two.
Needing twos. Yahtzee. No, not Yahtzee. But five wounds on them.
Five wounds.
Yeah. Markers before.
I know, yeah. I'm going to have to bust out my wound counters.
Five wounds on that unit. Starting with the grotesque units.
Eight plus
seven. No. Or plus six.
Nine.
Eight plus nine is 17.
17 wavered.
Wavered.
Yeah, we got 16, 18 on them.
Oh, so they're wavered. Oh,
lucky. Lucky to have stuck around.
Yeah. Oh, so Iron Caster?
No, I just don't think it's a good idea, but okay.
Six.
Six plus
nine.
15? 15. He's...
I think I'm 15, 17, so I'm wavered.
He is wavered, but he's wavered. Still on the board! All right.
Can't go forward.
And
all right. Next one will be these dogs right here.
These dogs.
Seven plus three is 10.
10. A-okay, 11-13.
Next dogs,
taking five.
Oh, alright, good.
They're still kicking.
Then your riders over there?
The Sons of Corgan. Alright, let's see.
Six. Six plus eight, 10, 12, so
18?
18? 16, 18. Oh, pop them.
Yep.
Poor Sons of Corgan. Alright, Helm of Confidence. Forcing the reroll.
Oh, even better.
Does that mean they really die?
Yeah. The pop. Damn. I'm attacking. D6 plus 6. So 8. 8 attacks hitting on 4s. Alright. Now wounded on twos. Because of crushing strength three. So four wounds on them.
On which one?
On the hounds.
Puppies.
Oh. So let's see what we get. Four plus.
Four.
Eight.
I'm good.
That guy has to back off. Back off. The giants. Yeah, the dogs are brave.
All of them.
Okay, now we're going to go into Efren's turn two.
My turn.
Charging the war machine right here.
I'm going to charge this war machine.
This war machine over here.
Crunch.
Maximize. Bam.
Does that work?
So these dogs charging into this war machine.
So they're going to pivot, and then you should be able to hit like that.
Yeah, you make contact. Then we got to... We'll do some charging.
Boom.
See, it's going to move forward. And
just put some weight on there.
Yeah.
So let's see. Go up to...
Boom.
It's kind of like that.
There you go. Moving forward and forth right there. Yeah, bait.
Boom.
Bam. Activating that unit.
So I'll pivot like that. And we'll go 12.
Right to there. Slayer's up 9. Boom. Advancing them up 4. Boom. Right to there. Done.
So I'll stay. I'm just going to send this as far as I can. They get 10 inches of movement, so I can go all the way up.
Right behind them.
Slayers.
Same thing for that unit, too. Right behind decimators. They're done. Alright, let's go forward. The forest is ours!
Hide behind this tree!
One tree!
They engulfed it.
Yeah. Completely surrounding the tree.
And then he's gonna change the facing a little bit, and we'll show you guys afterwards.
Move that to the side a bit, backed up his half-breeds, and pivoted a little bit to Slave Orcs.
Getting the regen.
Yeah, regen.
Or change faces.
Oh, 9 needing fives.
2.
2 more wounds given back to those guys. Bink.
Alright.
Just change his facing and he is done.
Yeah, that's all I can really do.
Alright. The Enclave firing. Needing 4s. 1 hit.
Blast. 2.
2. Piercing 2. Defense 4, so snake eyes means nothing. Alright, there, okay.
Done.
Done. And Countercharge.
That's all I got going?
Yeah.
That's like the longest turn ever.
All that time.
Advancing and shooting.
Oh, I got those 2 charges too.
Oh, yeah. You'll
right, so the Countercharge.
So you're going to kill the giant.
So no thunderous, right?
No thunderous because
you. Alright, so I need.
You got hit, right?
Yeah.
I need
Force.
That's pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah,
needing 6s though to hurt the giant. Or defense 5, sorry, defense 5.
5? 1?
1. Okay. Boxcars to waver. No, hey, he's guys. A-okay.
Exact opposite.
Alright. He backs off.
Yeah, I want to back off. Next, I guess on the next we're going right there.
30 attacks.
30.
Well, do Doom Waves 15. Doom Waves 15.
Nah.
You're going to grab all 30?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll get back to you after you grab all
30. 30 dice.
Needing force.
All right, needing force.
Because they charged their force.
So defense 5. So
that one?
5.
No one did charge.
They didn't charge? Okay, so five. Then force then.
Force.
Wow. Alright, so that's...
9.
Okay. 10, 12. 10, 12. 3, 12. You pop them.
I should do that right now, huh?
Yeah. You do it right now, yeah. Yeah.
Six.
Oh, any inspiring?
No.
No. So they're popped. I'll load them all for you.
Alright.
Okay, next 30 attacks.
So I got a reform right now?
Yes. This is the hindered unit that charged.
Yeah.
So 30 attacks hitting on fives. Okay, we'll get back to you after this. Alright, needing
fours?
Fives. Because no thunders.
Three.
Alright, let's see.
They've already sustained two from before.
Yeah. Oh, pop them. Any inspiring?
No.
No? Oh, they're dead.
Interesting.
And then this unit, now he gets a pivot. We'll get back to you after finished. And now we're going into...
Three.
Turn tres. Is that three yet? There you go. All right, so we'll look at the battlefield. No losses for the Abyssal Dwarves yet.
Oh, no. I lost one.
Oh, lost one Hound unit.
And the Mounted Suns.
Oh, and the Mounted Suns, yes. So it looks like this flank is super duper strong. Looks like it's getting ready to crush somebody. Dwarves are holding stern. Looking good. Alright, now we're going to go into turn three. Is it going to counter charge?
Counter charge. And this dwarf is going to charge
his... Charge the slayers.
Charge the slayers. They're going to be hindered. The end placement charging slayer units. Up right there.
And I'm going to turn.
Okay.
Then this one's going to charge into those guys.
So this unit is going to charge the flank of these dogies. Boom. Done. Ogres advancing up.
The ogres.
Right to here.
Hopefully you don't notice me blowing up the other.
Right there is their finish. And then the BSB is going to follow right behind.
Yep.
And then he'll be done. Pivoting this unit. And they're done. One bombard shot from the wall into the Ironcaster. Miss. Gonna do it again. Oh. Miss. Oh, one more time.
Third one.
Oh, he gets it. All right.
That was only one wound. D6. And then failed a wound.
D6. Five. Three. Eight wounds. Oh, man.
It's eight?
Eight.
D6
plus
three.
Oh, it's six. It's a D6. Yeah. Give me all ones.
Oh, let's see.
No. So what do you need? You needed threes, right?
Yeah.
Gosh. Eight wounds?
8 wounds on
it. Is that all?
Only that, all right. All right. That was your last wall one.
Yeah, that was my last wall shot.
Okay. 18 shots from this into the dog, or 15 shots into the dogs. Need fives. Okay. Five hits.
Wounding, piercing two, so wounding on twos?
Yep.
Everything.
Five more. Okay. Put him at eight. Wounding rifles into the orcs. They're eating the forest.
So hitting on...
Fives.
Sixes, because they...
Oh, sixes, because they, yeah, because they're cover. Yeah. Alright, name sixes.
These three. Piercing two.
Defense four, so twos. Okay, two wounds on them.
Okay.
Two wounds on the big orc units. The dork boys.
How many?
Two.
Two wounds on the
orcs? Shooters needing fives into the orc boys.
Needing fives?
Yeah. Okay. Piercing two again, so twos.
So six total?
Yep.
And another 18 force of boomers.
Yep.
From the shooters?
From the shooters.
Next for the boomers right here.
Oh, boomers. Boomers.
Yeah, boomers.
Oh, God.
It's a 4+.
Four plus.
4+. Actually, it's roughly the same odds. Okay, now you need
piercing
twos again. So the seven more.
Oof. 13 wounds already.
Alright, 13 wounds on the orcs.
Oh, and then the Bane Chant to the Iron Guard.
Bane Chant with Iron Guard. gets it.
Should I roll for nerves now? Let's start with that guy.
Nerve on the Supreme Ironcaster, who is the leader. Reroll because he's inspiring. Oh, he pops. Now, Efren takes a minus -2 to all his nerves.
Oh, that's painful.
Yeah.
It could be really painful.
For the rest of the game.
At least we got all these back.
Yeah. All right, now we're going to go into the next nerve.
The dogs?
The dogs. Okay.
5 + 8, 13. 13.
Okay. Nerve for the slave orcs.
We're talking
2022. No, 13. Plus 9,
22. 22. Pop.
With the minus -2?
And the minus -2 is even worse.
Minus -2, yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Pops him.
Pops him.
Oof.
Ouch. All right. Almost like, is there any...
attacks? D6 plus 6.
8.
8. 8 attacks, hand on force. Oof. So that's 5 hits.
5 fours.
Needing twos. Alright, so four more wounds. Putting him at...
8.
8, so nerve check.
12.
12.
They're good,
with
right?
The minus -2.
Oh, no, not for them, though. They're not.
A minus -3.
They're Varanger.
They're Varanger, so they don't get the minus
-2. Oh, so we don't get the minus -2.
Yeah,
so you're wavered. Realize that.
You're just wavered.
Okay. 10, 12.
No, 11, wait, 13. Wait.
Oh, the 11, 13.
Yeah, 13.
11,
yeah.
13.
They're wavered. So the giant backs off.
8, 4, 12. Yeah. Yeah, they survived it.
Yeah. Everett's so surprised.
I'm surprised.
All right.
Dogs survive a little 25
bit. 25 hindered attacks hitting on fives from the iron
shieldbreakers.
Shieldbreakers. Alright, now damaging them. Defense 3.
So defense 3. Where are we doing? Where is this?
The,
no, right there.
The crushing strength 2, so on 2s then?
Yeah, 2s. Overkill. Alright, so 6.
Slayers.
Slayers.
There's a nerf.
There's dash 13.
Yeah.
Dash 13? 12.
12.
What? Minus 2.
Minus 2. 2. Do they pop?
Yeah, they pop.
They pop. Wow.
Yeah. Boom. But that's a good thing.
Yeah.
So I want them out of the way.
No, I didn't want them.
Oh, this is gonna hurt. Don't. That was gonna slip.
So what are you gonna do with those guys?
Good. Just building up my reinforcements. That's all. So you should be jotting down
3 inches.
Why does it matter? To do less.
Times 2.
24. It's very rare for dwarves to flank somebody.
24 attacks into the flanks of the dukes.
Hitting on threes.
Hitting on threes. All right, we'll get back to you after we count. Hey. Now it needs twos.
Is that right there?
Yeah. And yeah, 2s even with Beige.
Gosh. They have crushing 2?
No, they have crushing 1 because of the Beige hand.
Crushing 1.
Yeah. Oh, crushing 1. Okay. So 3s.
That's still a lot.
So you're looking at snake eyes.
Yeah, I'm looking at snake eyes.
Yeah.
It's like they've taken 15. Like 20 wounds.
Yeah.
15 right there.
Snake eyes.
Snake eyes?
Oh, they pop.
So far.
What'd you have to do with these dudes?
We're going to pivot. That way.
Alright, done. This big doggy dude is charging into.
Boom.
Bam. Bam.
Bam, bam.
The effects say he is done. The decimators. Right to here. Boom. Another unit of decimators moving up.
Yeah. Boom.
There you go. This other one.
This other one.
Moving these guys up.
I'll pivot it first. About there. Then we'll move up. 4.
Okay.
there. Now I'll do double charge here.
Double charge from here.
This one, oh, it's got to go in the shortest distance, right?
Yeah.
And then, so it's going to be messed up and then moves over.
Yep. And hindered. And then the other unit's going to come in. We'll show you guys the end placement. That's the end placement of all the chargers. And then we're going to do some fiddling with this. The slave works 8 right to there.
Boom.
Boom. And then another iron caster.
So the slayers. Where are they going to go? Put the slayers out here.
Okay. 12 inches forward.
Yep. For 8. No, 10. Take out a 5 inch movement.
Charge. Boom. Okay.
And over here.
The iron caster.
Ironcaster, what's he gonna do?
Beeline, like.
Is it be like?
Is it returning?
20-inch move.
His Ironcaster brother.
He never really died. He just got back.
Flying up. Right over there. Oh, this giant's gonna deal have a lot of pain.
He also got a new pair of boots of levitation.
God. All right, now we're gonna go into shooting phase. I'm over.
Boom. And this one, well, I'm already in the forest. I'm just going to go forward.
Boom. And they're done. Now to shooting face. Yeah. 7 regens.
Healed 3.
Huh. Damn. Pretty good.
Yep.
These guys 14 inch forward.
Put a marker out there.
Yeah, we'll show you guys placement of the grotesques. Firing into the iron guard.
One
hit.
D3.
Piercing 2.
Piercing 2. One.
One wound on them. Nerve check.
15, 17.
9, 10.
They're out of here. No,
they're I'm just okay. kidding. Oh, yeah. <you're laughs> and they're done.
Yeah.
Is it going to do the shotgun tactic?
Yeah.
30 shots into the... You're just going to roll all 3. It doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
Into the giants. So 30 shots. Oh my god. Especially if they all had elite. If they had elite too. Shots from the giant. Get it on force. Pretty defense 5. Down the force.
The force ambitious.
Ambitious. No vicious. No vicious.
Not
no
single vicious. So that's 7 wounds. 7 wounds on 7 giant. Wounds putting him at 8. Giant.
Now I gotta fireball him.
Now fireball. Reinforce. Oof. Well, that's not pretty good, actually.
And then I need 5s.
And vicious.
No. 3 more.
3 more. Putting him at... 11.
11.
Yeah.
6, yeah, 11.
11. All right, let's see, Efren.
All right, so right there. Plus 8.
11 what?
Plus
8, 19. 19, that pops the giant.
Whoa.
All right. And bye-bye goes the giants.
Good thing my guys come back to life. It's the only way I was able to do it.
Because it's 17, 19, right?
Yeah.
So it was terrible
30,
when we did 2
30 shots.
Yeah, right into there.
Or 30 attacks from the Direfang guy. Hitting on 3s. Oh, God. Elite.
Elite.
All those elite ones.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Man.
I needed 3s, right?
Yeah, and then there's all those ones.
Elite.
Elite. Elite. You see, you can't see this huge smile on Efren's face as he picks up all these ones and gets to reroll.
There you go.
Yeah, all right.
And now minus 3, right?
Yeah,
2s to wound.
2s, oh my god.
I don't know if he has vicious. It doesn't matter.
Snake eyes. We're looking at snake eyes.
Snake eyes. 6.
6.
Any inspiring?
No. Oh,
nope.
Pop right. The war machine.
So that one doesn't inspire war machines?
No, it's only for...
just facing that way.
Alright, now.
Attacks right there from the Sons of Corgan. Oh, this is gonna hurt.
He got 30 space.
Okay. And now...
Wounding on two. Wounding, or, no, wait.
Defense four.
Defense four.
Crushing two.
So yeah, twos. Twos. Oh, did you do the hinder? Include the hinder?
No.
No, we had to...
yeah, right. So hitting on...
Fours.
Oh, only fours.
Hitting on fours.
20 attacks hitting on fours. And then right. Twos again.
Twos.
Vicious. Do, no, oh, no, they don't have vicious. Vicious.
They don't have vicious.
I think they're there.
Nine wounds from the Suns.
So nine wounds on nine wounds, and then second round of attacks.
So you're 16 coming from the Bull Centaurs.
Bull Centaurs.
Oh, yeah.
Half-breeds.
I mean,
half-breeds.
Half-breeds. Here we go.
Hit on threes. Boom. And no negative effects because they have
the caterpillar.
And they are wounding.
Minus two, so twos.
Getting twos again.
Twos again.
With vicious this time.
What did I give him? I give him a. Oh, I give him caterpillar.
Yeah.
Vicious.
Oh, man.
Wow.
Oh.
Boom.
Everything. How many wounds is that now?
It's a lot. 13.
13. Yeah.
So don't snake eyes.
Don't
snake eyes. Snake eyes.
Oh, snake eyes, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and pops that big there. Unit. And pops. Then we'll go back after Ephraim repositioned an inch from its D3. And boom. Done. They're going to sit tight. At the top of turn 4. Bam. All right, man. So it's up to the dwarves to try to do another counterattack. This is a really big turn for Ephraim. Did a lot of charges.
Oh, yeah, so I should figure
a
out
a lot of maneuvering. Let's see how it goes for the dwarves on turn 4. Ooh, the decimator's up.
Oh, yeah.
No. Boomers.
Boomers. Yeah. I'm an ogre player. Why did I say that? Mm-hmm. Moving boomers up.
Oh, well, that'd be blocking them, huh? Oh no, well, I'll be shooting those guys.
Yeah, fine. Doing the boomers up right to there. Advance these guys up. And they're done.
Pivot.
And they're done. Pivoting the orcs. Ogres.
Hey, you're an ogre player, man.
I know, I'm getting forward. Moving forward right to there. And then they're done.
BSBs.
Boom. So pivoting the Iron Watch right to there. They're done. Yeah, walking and going around and right behind.
I'm gonna look at them so they can
Bane Chant. Yeah. Alright. Then going right into shooting.
Bane Chant to these guys.
Yep, Bane Chant. Need two dice. Boom. Got it.
Piercing three now.
Yes.
Lightning Bolt into those wolves.
Lightning Bolt into the dogs. Here's Lightning Bolt six. Let's see. All right.
Three
piercing one.
So I think
wound
number three?
Yep.
Two more wounds.
Two more wounds.
Okay, 7, 8, and 10. 10, so what? 13?
13.
Yeah, well, even.
Wall into one. These guys down here. All right. Only two. Defense four, so needing threes. Only one wound. Oh, one wound on the airs, guys.
This one?
Yeah.
Oh, no, this one.
On the decimators?
Decimators, yeah. Yeah, lightning bolt in the same decimator unit. Okay. Only three. Piercing two. So two more. Putting them at three.
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 All
right. All these shots. 25 shots?
20.
20 shots into the...
Is that from the Horde over there?
Yeah, the Horde.
The Abyssal.
Into the
half-breeds. Hitting eating sixes.
Sixes?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
of
the terrain. Only three.
Piercing three because of the Bane Chant.
Needing twos. So this one you're going to roll all ones.
Three wounds.
Three wounds on them. Let's see.
That's all. We're starting with the wolves. And they're
for
the wolves.
And they're for the dogs. Meaning snake guys. No.
They nope. They're gone.
6 inches?
Nah, it looks like more. Yeah. Boom. Like 8.
They're popped.
Decimators?
Decimators, let's see. They've taken 4 damage.
They've taken 3.
Oh, 7,
so 10. So 10. They're wavered.
They're wavered.
Oh, no, they're popped. Minus 2? They're 12. Oh, 10, 12. Gone.
They pop.
Yeah, they're popped.
Boom.
10, 12.
Bam. Rolling for these guys. Oh, 3. They're A-okay. All right. Let's see how... Now we're going to go into Efren's turn 4.
My turn 4.
Let's see how they do. Decimator doesn't come behind the books around the corner. Efren was thinking he could be sneaky and hiding him. His enclave.
Boom.
Bam. Alright. He's going to do his free reposition because he's individual. He's going to move up.
5.
And then he is done.
Yep.
Dancing these guys up.
Okay.
So pivoting them in sideways. Getting out of the way.
Does that actually get them out of the way? That doesn't get them out of the way.
Sideways 3 inches from where he was. And then now we do
whose wounds are
charge.
These?
Do a double charge with his grotesques and his to his leader unit. But there's no duration for both of his.
There's grotesques.
Grotesques.
2.
2 back.
So I need 2 wounds.
2 more on that unit. And then for his half-breeds, 3 regens.
Yep. Save 1.
Go 1. So puts him back at 2.
Alright.
And... Okay. Now going into different shooting.
Well, I gotta still move.
Oh, yeah. Moving. It over. And then it's going to move.
Move up 5. Boom.
He is done.
This one will do the same thing.
Move over, moving 5 into the forest.
This castle is actually really in the way. It's like hard to move. It's hard to do stuff.
Move up right to there. Yeah, we'll go ending right there. Move them over and then advancing them.
Yeah.
And they're done. He went his dragon from over there to here. Advancing his decimators. Advancing more decimators this way.
And shoot at the wall later.
Shoot at the wall. Yeah, MVP goes to the wall, guys.
5.
And bam. And... Pixels are awesome. He gets to reposition the shooting phase. He's going to take a shot at the ogres?
Ogres.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll shoot these ogres.
Yeah. Two shots, needing 5. Fours.
Boom, boom.
2 hits. D3 each.
3 total.
Yep, 3. Piercing 2, needing 3s.
1.
1. Only 1. No vicious. Okay. And no other shooting. So needing snake eyes.
Snake eyes,
yeah. Or sorry, boxcars.
8.
8.
So 9.
Okay. He's A-okay.
Cool. Let's do that combat.
Time for the big mamma jamma. From the half-breeds into
Iron
Guard.
So here's 3 sitcha.
Get in on 3s. Okay. Pretty good.
And now 2s? What do you have? 6?
6.
Minus 2. 4s.
Is it Thunderous 2 and...
No, Thunderous 1.
Thunderous 1, Crush Bond, so minus 2, okay. Vicious. There we go.
Boom. That's pretty good, right?
Wow.
4s? Yeah, 4s.
4s. Oh.
7 wounds.
7 wounds on him. Ooh. And then the second with the grotesques.
Yeah, this is 18 attacks.
Hitting on 3s because of Brew of Sharpness. Yep. Makes her fists sharper for some reason.
Yeah. Threes to hit you.
Pretty good.
And now twos to wound. Well, minus three.
Minus three. So threes to wound. With vicious.
Vicious.
And no twos. Oh my god.
There's a two.
There's one miss. How many wounds?
Lot. 14.
14 wounds.
Snake eyes.
21.
Snake eyes, I was looking at.
Yeah, snake eyes. Pop.
Alright.
Pops a. Bam. And then we'll show you end position after our friend decides what he's going to do with these two units.
Position for those two units. Alright, now going into dwarf turn 5. Super bloody.
Has been, yeah.
Let's see. Starting dwarf turn 4. He's going to charge his ogres into these orcs, slave orcs. And they're done. Boomer's pivoted to get a chance to shoot.
Right now, the bane chance into my dwarves.
Now, no other movements.
I get it.
Bane chanted.
And then 20 dices.
And he's got shooting. Shots into the half breeds. Needing fives. Okay.
Elite would have been nice.
Yeah. Boom. Piercing two, needing twos.
So piercing three.
Oh, piercing three. Oh, it's a bane chance. So twos.
Everything.
Those always twos.
Is this seven?
Seven wounds on them.
Yep. There's a whole bunch right here.
Yep. Six.
You need one?
Yeah, one. Boom.
I guess the. What's her name?
Boomer's firing into.
Half breeds. Four plus.
Pretty good. We'll get back after this. Piercing two. Wow.
Three, six, nine more?
So nine more.
Nine more.
Okay.
So we're looking at 18, so it's already double ones.
Yeah. My shooter's into your grotesque.
Grotesque, so you're needing fives. That's a lot of fives. All right.
Eight, piercing two.
So do you need threes?
Four wounds
on him. Bam. Alright, now the wall.
Okay, it's gonna be all lightning bolts. Should I just roll 18 then?
You can do that, yeah.
Well, you should save
bolt into the grotesque from the wall.
Piercing okay. One, so on fours, right?
Need fours. So two more wounds on him. Okay.
Well, eight? Oh,
yeah.
They're
taking 10.
Oh, they're 10?
Oh, no, they're taking 10. No.
Yeah.
So can't add.
Piercing one. We go for this.
Oh. Ooh, only one more.
One more wound for them. I guess I will have to use all three.
Yep. Last lightning bolt.
Piercing one. Okay. We go for this. Ooh. Three more. Here's the nerve for them. They're at.
The grotesques are 16, 18.
So
minus two.
So minus two, so.
Minus two.
14, 16?
14, 16 for the group.
5 plus 6, 11.
Yeah, 17.
17, so. Oh, they're dead.
They don't get inspiring from the other general?
No. Pop.
Dang. Grotesque going down.
But not you, nerve charging.
Six plus. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah.
Is that popped. For who?
For your half breed.
That's
right.
For them. Oh, yeah. Man.
18. Put Heffron. Next turn, that ogre unit is dead. Yeah. Attacks from these ogres into the orcs.
Ooh. What am I wounding at fives?
Hitting on threes.
Oh, threes. Never mind.
Their lead infantry. Alright. And wounding. Crushing one, so needing threes.
Who's shooting?
Melee.
Oh, melee.
Threes? three, six, eight.
8 wounds on the these guys.
The nerve.
All right.
8
plus 8 is 16. 16 plus brutal.
They have brutal 22.
And they're minus 2.
And minus 2.
Yeah.
They might be dead.
17.
Oh, what is it?
17. Nope.
You rolled 8 plus 5?
Plus 8. So this is 8 plus another 8.
Oh, there's 8 here?
Yeah.
So
the ogre's old.
Can contribute in this combat.
Charging. Dire Fang.
Boom.
And smack.
Good.
Double charging. Cha-cha.
Boom, boom.
Bam. And bam.
Okay.
All right. And then
these come back to life.
Yep. Seeing these guys 16 inches forward.
Boom.
And they're done right there.
Okay.
And that's the Magus Enclave. This way. And
these I still get another pivot, right?
Yeah. It's done. Just hiding right behind. They're done.
Okay. Give
them up 5 inches. And they're done. Up forward. Boom. They're done. Dancing this unit up. Sprinting.
Boom.
And the Slayer's sprinting.
Yeah, they might as well just go all the way up here.
Yeah. That's a forward. And they're done.
Well, they're going to shoot at the wall crew.
And fly him over.
And we'll be going at the double. Yeah, and that's all they can really do. All
right. And he is going right in the shooting.
All right, I'm going to start off with the fireball.
Fireball from the wizard into... The horde of gunners.
There we go. 10 shots.
10 shots. Hitting on fours.
Hitting on fours.
Wait, is he 12 inches, right?
12 inch. Out of range, huh? No, it's
okay. No, you're good.
Yeah.
And then,
defense
fives? Fours?
Defense four.
Four.
Oh, I have, oh.
4 wounds.
4 wounds on him. That's the only shooting. So needing boxcars to waver. No, they're okay.
Yeah.
Alright, so you want to do the fun part, Efren?
Oh, like that combat?
Yeah.
I should get all the way.
Attacks basically. Against his stone priest.
Here we go. Threes to hit. We have to leap.
No, thank God for the lead, right?
Six
wins, huh? Oh my God. Double leap.
Yeah, no. And then this is all twos.
Meaning twos. Boom.
5 wounds.
5 wounds on the stone priest.
Well, 5 wounds means the average roll will pop them.
Yeah.
3, right?
Yeah, Christian, yeah. 3. A 5. I rolled a 5. Plus a 10. Plus a minus 2.
So you rolled a 10.
12.
So 11, 13. It's wavered.
So 20. Yep, wasn't able to pop them. All right, other combats though. It looks like you're gonna win this one for sure.
Maybe. Last.
So 20 attacks from the Slayer. 20 attacks from the Slayer unit. Let's see, hitting on fours. Oh, 40 attacks actually.
40.
Yeah. He's attacking. 25 attacks.
All right, here we go. 25 attacks. Oh, I need a yellow-bellied roll.
Yellow-bellied.
Right?
Front yellow-bellied.
Motherfucker.
Are you kidding me?
Third yellow-belly roll. So I need to back up. Oh my God. I'll put on about the yellow-belly so this unit doesn't get to charge. So it's just the Slayers.
Just the Slayers.
Three attacks. We're needing fours. Oh.
Alright.
How many hits?
That's more than 20.
Yeah.
Now it's
crushing one, so down to force. Oh, yeah.
Force to wound. Vicious. So just a few.
Oh my god.
This is force to wound?
Force, yeah. Wound, yeah. That was a good little thing.
They're pissed. Had to show the orcs how to do it.
Oh god. What was
that's,
it?
That's why they're not the slaves.
Mm-hmm. I got well over 15. This one I just flipped with my finger.
Yeah.
I got 20.
20.
So snake eyes.
So snake eyes, please.
Wow.
Yeah.
But slayers alone.
You didn't need the orcs.
Yeah.
Pop.
There you go.
Damn. Oh, BSP? Is he within 6?
Maybe.
He's a widget.
See if it matters. No. Doesn't matter.
But you were in range.
Yeah. Well, then that's the roll. Yeah. 3.
Pop them. That's their end position.
20 wounds out of 40?
Yeah.
That was the
so
average.
Now it's.
Yeah, but
dwarf.
I wasn't even rolling.
Turn 6. Yeah, the final turn. Or there might be another turn in the game, depending if we roll facing that way. Boom.
And I think that's the only movement.
All right.
Yeah, this is.
So that probably takes away the charge from this.
Strong Zone Priest. It's headstrong, so it can countercharge. So is the Stone Priest going to countercharge?
Yeah, I suppose you don't have to.
Yeah. He can't cast spells.
I should be actually an inch back right now, right?
Yeah. Countercharge.
Yeah, countercharge.
Bam.
You'll run out of the way. No.
That's because you want to protect your...
But it would prevent me from being able to charge you back. These guys?
20 shots into these dudes.
From there?
Yeah.
Alright.
5?
5s.
Can't even see.
Here's some 2. Down to 3s.
3s.
Got 3s. Alright. Missed one. So I 8 hits. 8
wow.
Wounds.
8 wounds.
Into the Sons, huh?
Yeah.
Yep. 8 wounds of the Sons of Korgan.
Does this unit?
Yeah, the, this one right here.
I was thinking of that one. But it doesn't really make too much of a difference.
There we go. Shots from the shooters into...
The same group.
Same group. Needing a force, because there's no intervening terrain or models.
Wow.
Ooh. Still pretty decent, actually. Now you need...
Threes again. Eight more.
Ooh. Put him at 16.
16.
Oh, god damn it. Yeah, 3.
So I need snake eyes.
Alright, and then the boomers into your Bissell Dwarves.
Boomers and the Bissells.
There's 4 of you? Yeah, 4. 4.
Yep.
Piercing 2, so on 2s, winning on 2s. 4, 6, 8.
8 in here?
Yep.
Ouch, that's really big. There you go.
So 8. Okay.
Now who am I going to lightning? What's his nerf?
Your combat.
Oh yeah, he's in combat, never mind.
Yeah. 3 bombard shots into...
Here's the first one.
First one. Needing 5. No. Second one. No.
Wow, 2-1.
Third one. No.
All right.
So 3 rocks, and he dodged all 3.
Yeah,
he
dodged them all.
All right, now it's...
Nerves?
Nerve tests. So we'll do this Sons of Korgan.
Jinking.
Jinking?
Yeah.
That's snake
40K.
Eyes, right?
Yeah, snake eyes. They pop. This
Was it? Which one? This unit?
Yeah, it pops. And then these guys?
6 plus
they pop 2.
They
8,
pop.
Yeah.
So 2 units popped.
14. Oh, man.
And add those Orange things. Stone Priest whacking him with a stick. 1 hit. Defense 5. He hurts him. So he doesn't get the overrun next turn.
Oh, dude.
Oh, he's a nerf?
Nerf.
Nerf. Boxcars.
15-17.
Hey, okay.
Boom.
All right.
Back up an inch.
Now it's worth doing the flank charge with the abyss, the sorcerer lord. Flying in this flank, not a dragon, but bounce of half breed. Yeah,
plus you should have took those 3 points actual on those decimators, lightning bolt.
Yeah. Boom. Then charging in the front. Bam. Whackety whack. Don't talk back.
I'll just take these off. yeah. Charge that way. Yeah. This will go there.
Yeah.
Oh, but this one's... What if I charge here and then that one goes there?
So, half-breeds charging into the boomers.
We have a caterpillar, you know, if I clip the
bink
forest there.
And these guys charging in. They don't care. Well, they're still going to be impeded, but... It's a BSB.
Okay.
All right. Everything else, everyone doesn't want to move closer.
This is all dead, right?
Yeah. And then we'll go into shooting.
I'll just move to this. Up. That's 8.
At this point, just
done.
Get the most points.
Done moving there. He counter charges. Now we're going right into the combats.
Is he shooting? No, I have no
shooting.
Maybe. Can I shoot at the.
18 attacks from the grotesques into the BSB.
I don't know. Actually, I'll talk to him. Here we go. Alright, so here's a force to hit you because of the force. You recording?
Yeah. Force to hit.
This is missed anyway. And no thunderous.
So crushing 2, so. Oh, what was the defense there?
4.
So 2s.
2s.
Me and 2s. The vicious.
And the vicious. 7.
7 wounds.
And we resolve that right now, right?
Yeah. And brutal.
Stay, guys.
9.
Brutal. 7. Inspiring.
Because he inspires himself.
10.
And 10.
Even better.
Yeah. Pop.
Pop him.
Surge forward, okay. D6. None of that matters.
3 inches.
3 inches.
Yeah. He's in the fort.
Does it really matter?
Just put it right there. Yeah, if it matters, we'll put the unit up there.
16 right. Attacks.
Yep.
Hit it on 3s.
I'm gonna roll it over here. Alright. Hitting on 3s.
1 miss.
1 miss. And now I got thunderous 1.
Crushing 1. Crushing 1. 2s.
2s.
The defense 4. And reroll vicious.
Boom. So is that, it should be 15, right?
Yeah. Oh my god.
15 wounds.
15 wounds.
That's snake eyes?
Snake eyes. Pop.
Popped.
Popped him. Bam.
Surge forward. 6 inches.
6 inches? Here you go.
Oh yeah.
We're on you! Alright.
There.
You want to
start with the sons.
Yep. Alright, let's see.
This is 20, right? Kind of did it too fast.
Let's just say it is. I'm pretty sure they're going to
die. Yeah. Yeah, it's 20.
Alright, yeah. 20 attacks.
Threes.
Threes.
Oh, I'm getting brain dead, man.
It's happens when we play 2 games.
It's 3. Twos? 2-7.
It's been a long day.
No
vicious?
No vicious.
So that is...
13.
13 wounds on him. Put him at 17. And then your 10 attacks from your caster.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's up here then. Alright. 10. 10 from the wizard.
No rolling fours.
Ooh. And now minus two for crushing.
So twos and vicious.
Vicious.
So four more.
That's a lot. All right.
21.
So you snake eyes.
Okay.
So you snake eyes? No. Boom. Pops them. Then you've got your 10 attacks from your dire fang.
Yeah. He should have finished them a long time ago. He decided to play with them. All right, 10 from the dire fang.
Yeah.
Threes.
With elite.
Oh yeah, there was one.
Yeah. Boom. Twos.
Twos. Five so wounds.
Five more.
To the caster.
All right. Let's see if it.
Break waiver test or whatever. Three.
Plus five.
So
eight.
Five. How many has he got?
Five.
Eight.
So he's
13.
Taking
10.
13.
He's dead. Yeah. Boom. And then. Okay, now we'll do all your repositioning and then we'll be done. We need a 4 plus to see if the game ends or continues. We need a 4 plus to see if the game continues.
One.
It's over. So we'll calculate the points and we'll tell you guys who the victor is.
All right, we just finished. So the score by 50 points goes to the
dwarf. No,
it was more than 50, no? 50. 50. 50. Oh. Well, by 50 points, the score went to the dwarves.
Yeah,
it was 350, really but yeah.
Okay, I see what you're saying.
But yeah, but we were joking about throughout the whole game, like feed it to the wall, let the wall eat everything, because that wall rule is really strong.
Yeah, the wall
I think,
is really powerful.
Because in the book, it's Basilians and it says Basilians and Dwarves, but the thing about it is like the weapon options for the Basilians was their arbalest. They're crossbowmen and a lightning bolt six, which we were talking about afterwards. It seems like maybe because of dwarves, how shooty they are as a faction might cut that down into just two. But they did do a lot of work, though. I mean, just like the bombard with your
early
your caster's like, turn all right, turn one, and then waiver two, the
waiver. Yeah, he got wrecked at the beginning.
But it should have been, if we did a cannon, then he could have at least gotten cover behind the forest, making it, instead of a 5 to a 6, a little bit easier. Because the bombard is really good. I mean, just being able to just like lob shots in there.
Well, all he needs is line of sight, and he had, what, height 6?
Yeah, yeah, height 6, which is understandable for where you have a wall.
No, I thought it was a really great match, though. It was a really cool siege.
Next
you know, I felt this was like a way better siege than the one that we had, because that one had like funny rules. But this one, like, really felt more.
Yeah, because, like, with the being
felt
close
better.
To the wall and stuff like
that.
Yeah. Well, the having the wall rules really do make it. Actually, that might, if we ever do a siege game, we might want to consider that again.
That way?
Yeah, yeah. Doing that instead of.
Yeah, it was a lot. I think it was a lot better.
It's a really.
Than the last
it's a
one.
Really
it was a lot more balanced.
Yeah, it's
than
a,
the
yeah, because.
Even though one, even though we're talking about how powerful the wall was, I think it was still really.
But for
fun
but for like a thousand, you got also we also got to think about like you had an extra 1,000 points in your army to his. 2,000.
Mm-hmm.
So I mean, like, maybe you could, in theory, make the wall stronger, and then just make the defense force like 1,000 points of defense, and giving a wall like 6 actions and stuff like that. So like 6 war machines.
Well, you did that yellow belly.
Yellow
belly.
Okay, so
brutal.
You guys saw like
gosh.
You guys saw the yellow belly thing because we did 2 games in 1 day, and this is an in a row. This is the third time that same unit yellow belly, and we were all discussing about why take a Abyssal Dwarf unit when you can get an Orc unit that does practically the same thing for the same price? Or no, for cheaper. It's like 100 points, like 40
points.
Yeah, yeah.
40 points cheaper. But then Yellow Belly.
Twice. Which was it was one of the main things, one of the main reasons I never brought him before.
Yeah.
Besides not having the painted models. But now that I picked him up, you know, I thought I would give him a shot, but.
I think they're good for the cost. The Yellow Belly. That was just in a really crazy.
Oh yeah, it was a really terrible.
Yeah, like the likelihood.
Yeah, I know that. Yeah, the likelihood is terrible.
Yeah. Any last thoughts? Anything that like you guys really liked or?
Yeah, I just thought it was a really good game.
It was really. It looked
I think it was really like cinematic. I really liked the way the wall was just this like unknowing amount of like troops behind the wall, just raining down stuff on the attackers. I think it was really cool.
And just being able to
I think it felt more of a siege than it did in the previous siege game.
So instead of you spending points on like siege equipment and stuff like that, it's literally just you put your army in front of the wall and you try. Because one thing that was really interesting about this, they did the points differences, where it was like, Efren, you had 3,000 points, and he had to win by 30% of your army.
Mm.
And then he had, for you to beat him, you had to win by 20% of your army. And like also being able to get those additional actions from the wall. I think it's a good balance. We have to play more games, but I think it's a really good mechanic. I like it a lot. What about you, man?
That was...
It was a long game.
We've been recording for almost 8 hours. So. Two games, by the way. Alright, well, I think we're just rambling on right now. So we'll see you guys in week 3 and 4. So the score is 1 victory for the good, 2 victory for the evil. Or 1 victory for good and 1 victory for evil. Yeah, we're tired. Yeah. Alright, see you guys later. Bye.